est molestam senectutem, nos habebitumus, nos habebitumus. Vivat academia, vivat professores, vivat academia, vivat professores, vivat membrum quod libet, vivat membra quel libet, semper sit in flore, semper sint in flore.
Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga hoe fa, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Pro-Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, special guests, graduands, whānau and supporters. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of council members and staff of the university. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland, at which the Pro-Chancellor and I will award diplomas and confer degrees in the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries and the Faculty of Science. Graduation is a time for celebrating success. Today, you will experience the pomp and tradition of this ancient ceremony and the recognition befitting your success on your well-deserved day of celebration. Like your family and friends gathered here, we are very proud of all your achievements and look forward to your lifelong involvement as members of the University of Auckland family. Of course, graduation represents more than just a day of celebration. Your qualification from this university will have a lifetime impact on you, your family, and the community at large. We know that, compared to those whose formal education ends in high school, graduates have lower unemployment rates, higher salaries, better career prospects, and better health outcomes. Universities New Zealand has estimated that the lifetime benefits of earning a degree are valued at between $1 million and $4 million. Your university experience and the qualifications gained at this university will add real value to your lives and to the lives of those around you. The fact that our university can add value in these ways reflects the abilities and achievements of our staff and students. In the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries, we've seen several notable achievements in the last year. Associate Professor Ray DeLeal from the School of Music was named a member of the New Zealand Order of Merit for Services to Music. Emeritus Professor Sir Harold Marshall was awarded the 2015 Raleigh Medal for outstanding contributions to acoustics. Associate Professor Peter Robinson from the Elam School of Fine Arts had a work commissioned by renowned art institute, Centre Pompidou, in Paris. And Tonga Manasi Latu, a vocal student from the School of Music, was awarded a 2015 Creative New Zealand Arts Pacifica Award in recognition of his outstanding contribution to Pacific arts. Similarly, in the Faculty of Science, Dr. Alex Taylor won the MacDiarmid Emerging Scientist Prize at the 2015 Prime Minister's Science Prize Awards for his research into the evolution of intelligence. Distinguished Professor Margaret Brimble was named one of the year's Distinguished Women in Chemistry, or Chemical Engineering, by the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Associate Professor Katha Simpson won the Baldwin's Researcher Entrepreneur Award at this year's KiwiNet Research Commercialisation Awards. In addition, her spin-out company, Engender, won the AgTech section of the third annual World Cup Technology Challenge in Silicon Valley. And Professors Alexei Drummond and Thomas Lumley and Associate Professor Janet Wilmshurst were elected Fellows of the Royal Society of New Zealand. We can rightfully be proud of these achievements. In my view, to ensure that we can continue to achieve successes like these and to enhance our contribution to future generations of graduates and to our nation, the university must do three things. First, we need to attract students of high academic potential and give them an outstanding academic and extracurricular experience. In this respect, I believe we're doing very well. The proportion of domestic students entering the university with a high grade point average is growing each year, and we produce outstanding graduates just like you. Second, we need to attract, develop, and retain outstanding staff. This we are doing, as illustrated by the achievements I've just read. Many of our staff are world leaders in their fields, and you will have been privileged to learn from and work with them. It is no coincidence that, in the QS World Rankings of University Subjects, the University of Auckland came top in 35 of the 40 ranked subjects, and we don't even teach two of them. And third, we need to create the kind of academic environment and facilities that support and encourage excellence. To this end, the university has been investing heavily in its campus renewal program so as to ensure that we provide facilities of genuine international quality. Many of you will graduate today with the first qualification, and you will be rightly proud of this achievement. However, I also want you to reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. You see, you must never rest on your laurels in a challenging and ever-changing world, but rather be prepared to embrace change and new technology, and make the most of the opportunities presented to you. Although it may seem a daunting prospect right now, further study and learning is inevitable for us all as the world changes around us at an ever-accelerating pace. So whatever path you follow, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. However, today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. It's my pleasure to introduce you to Gareth Cronin, an alumnus of our business school and Vice President of Engineering for the Wynyard Engineering Group. In this position, he's responsible for growing and leading the company's engineering and development group, which has teams in Christchurch and Auckland, where they are building products to protect companies and countries from threat, crime, and corruption. Gareth has more than 15 years of technology and leadership experience in rapidly growing product environments and leads teams through periods of significant expansion. In the course of his successful career, he has developed software solutions for KiwiPlan New Zealand Limited, Orion Health, and now the Wynyard Group, attaining senior leadership positions in all three organisations. As the development manager for KiwiPlan, he led the developers of a suite of logistics and continuous scheduling applications for supply to the packaging manufacturing industry. At Orion Health, he led the product development group and teams responsible for building the company's products in its global development centres. Gareth, we look forward to hearing your address.
G'day. Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of council, members of the university, graduands, family and friends, kia ora koutou. I'm very, very glad to be here today, and I'm not just saying that, I actually really love graduation. I love it so much that I've crossed this stage three times in the last 15 years, and as the Chancellor was just saying, I think that opportunity for continuing education is one of the wonderful things about having a relationship with a university. I love graduation so much, I actually still watch the procession. We have an office down on Lawn Street, and when I hear the pipes and the drums coming down, I always go downstairs, even though I don't usually know anyone in the actual parade other than my brother, who's often carrying the flag at the front. I just love the pomp and the circumstance, the ceremony, the wonderful things about a ritual. There's not many rituals left to us, particularly Pākehā secular rituals here in New Zealand. Weddings and funerals are about it. Weddings are very happy occasions, and graduation is another one of those very happy celebrations. So, you know, I really am happy to be here. I'm going to tell you a little bit about my story and what brought me here, and in the process, I'm going to basically thank you for what you've done, because what you've done so far is a really important thing, and I hope you will keep on doing it. I'm a failed rock star. So another polite way to put it is a late bloomer. I grew up in a small town called Whakatane in the Bay of Plenty. Many of you may know it. It's a pretty place. It's a pretty place to visit. It's not such a pretty place to grow up. You'll know that, hopefully, that 80s TV theme about wanting to go where everybody knows your name. Sometimes you want to go where no one knows your name, or at least not everybody knows your name. I loved music. I dreamt of being a rock star, and I spent more time on music than I did on academic study at school. So I ended up leaving high school a little bit earlier than most people are supposed to leave high school, and I rushed up to Auckland, where I had a girlfriend at the time, and I wanted to be a rock star. So I joined bands, I played in bands, but one of the things about rock stardom is ambition is that your odds of success are fairly low. So without rock star good looks, and I'm wearing a trencher today, so you can't observe my premature hair loss, but without those good looks, those looks and the good luck and timing that's required, what I actually ended up doing was teaching children piano and playing in covers bands. Now, both of these things are worthwhile occupations, but perhaps not for too many years. So I'm sure most of you were great students when you were sent along to music lessons and did your practice and enjoyed being there. But it turns out that the majority of students are actually only there because their parents sent them. Covers bands, well, Yes, I'll let you form your own opinions about what it's like to make your way around what are often known as the meat markets of Auckland. I had another love, though, which I'd been so busy doing music that I'd forgotten about, and that was my love of computing and creating software. And I wasn't the sort of kid with a computer who made computer games. I actually used to do things like creating a toy banking system so that we could use it in our games at home, or a spreadsheet. I was very fortunate to be able to enter this university on special admission, which is a wonderful system. That means if you were like me and a bit of a late bloomer, you can actually come into the university age 20, even though you've got no formal university entrance. I very much enjoyed my study. I entered computer science. 4 years later, I graduated with a Bachelor of Science Honours in computer science, and I graduated top of my class. And the reason I was able to do that was because of the great teaching I had, but also my love for the subject and my love for what I was doing. I got a scholarship to a low-profile New Zealand success story, which was mentioned before in the intro, called KiwiPlan, where I found myself solving the problems of the world in cardboard box factories. Well, that doesn't sound exciting. What I learned about software was that there are fascinating problems to be solved everywhere. It doesn't really matter where they are. It's applying those skills actually produces an amazing thing that helps people do their jobs and helps countries make money. The other thing that comes with companies like software companies is that they grow fast. They create opportunities. I got leadership opportunities very early in my career, which I'm very grateful for, and I left KiwiPlan leading all of their engineering team. However, I didn't really understand what was going on in management meetings. I didn't know about anything about accounting or finance or anything like that. So I returned to Auckland to do my MBA at the suggestion of the owner of KiwiPlan. I returned to do my MBA because I thought it was going to teach me things like accounting and business and so on. But what it instead taught me was where I fit into New Zealand, where New Zealand fits into the world, and what it is that makes this place that we all love and we all love living in. We still have the dairy price on the front page of our newspaper. We had the CEO of Fonterra apologising to the whole country because they found some botulism in some milk powder. We still export raw logs and bring finished furniture into the country. We can't keep doing that. We're slipping down our ranking as far as economic productivity goes in the OECD because we're continuing to rely on these things. What I learned through that process and finding my place in the world and understanding about high-value exports was that I really wanted to work somewhere that was growing even faster and doing bigger things, so I moved to Orion Health. At Orion Health, I started with a team of 150 in Auckland, and I left with a team of 350 spread around Thailand, Phoenix in the US, Canberra, Christchurch, Auckland. I was able to travel the world, and I was able to contribute to transforming healthcare for the better for everybody. Eventually, though, I sort of wanted to try doing the same thing again, but somewhere else. So I moved to Wynyard Group. We make crime-fighting software, so we make software where basically the people who work for us get to catch bad guys from the comfort of their desks. It's a wonderful thing. It's a noble cause, and you don't have to wear a bulletproof vest or carry a gun or anything like that. So in summary, what I'm basically saying to you is that what you've done, what you've prepared yourselves for, that is exactly what this country needs. It's the technology, it's the creativity, it's the things of high value that we need to send to the rest of the world that are going to bring us back up that world ranking. Often we hear about the college dropout made big. So we hear about Bill Gates, we hear about Steve Jobs. They're a bit like rock stars. The odds of them getting into that position were very, very slim, especially having dropped out of university and not completing. So by all means, you know, stay foolish and stay hungry and all that sort of good stuff. That's good, you should do that. But I think what's important to realise is that taking that degree, that ritual, that rite of passage, what you've learned, what you've committed to, and what you've finished, it allows you to take your place on the stage as far as New Zealand goes, but it also helps New Zealand take its place on the world stage. Thank you.
Thank you, Gareth, for a most insightful and challenging address. Would you please join with me in thanking Gareth once again? This is a meeting of Council and Convocation of the University, at which the Pro-Chancellor, Scott St. John, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Scott St. John, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who within the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries and the Faculty of Science have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries, Professor Diane Brand, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries. To the degree of Bachelor of Architectural Studies, Adil Navid Baluch. Casey Alm Hemingway. Mataki Tatahi Te Whareiti Tui Tutangi Kauri Morihu Rawiri MacDonald. To the degree of Bachelor of Dance Studies, Amelia Chong Swetre. Rezan van der Ross. Jia Tong Zhang. To the degree of Bachelor of Music, Michael James Collier. Bing Ching Han. Lisiate Va'i Loa Haunga. Hyun Ah Lee. Finau Savilio Pole. Timothy Alexander Stanton. To the degree of Bachelor of Planning with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Chow Chu Lee. To the degree of Bachelor of Music Conjoint, Nicholas Lyndon Allen, and Bachelor of Arts, Jonathan Martin Cruz, and a Bachelor of Science. Stallone D'Souza, and a Bachelor of Science. Tommy Lawrence Hatchard McGill, and a Bachelor of Arts. Shina Valerie Magno Urando, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Heidi Tess Lovett, and a Bachelor of Science. Postgraduate Diploma in Music. Sine Ku in Performance. Sophia Fung Ying Lai. Wang Xiao Xuan. To the degree of Music Honours with First Class Honours, Margaret Grace Neal in Classical Performance. To the degree of Bachelor of Fine Arts Honours, Conjoint with First Class Honours, Alice Kathleen King and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Bachelor of Fine Arts Honours, Conjoint with Second Class Honours, First Division, Claire Whitehurst, and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Master of Architecture with First Class Honours, Sudeh Soleimani Ashtiani. To to the degree of Master of Architecture, Nan Lee in Sustainable Design. Simin Muhammad Ali Tajrishi. To the degree of Master of Architecture Professional with First Class Honours, Eric Franco Maria Abba. Shrija Bazak. Sophie Elizabeth Diong Bioletti. Ryan Marcus Brent. William Daniel James Brooks. Lin Bing Chen. University Graduate Scholar Tessa Elizabeth Ford. Eleanor Louise Glenton. Bennett James Hume. Chirag Jindal. Nicholas Rob Johnston. Amrita Kaur. Erica Claire Kenny. Donna Lee. Sung Hoon Lee. Ji Hei Lim. Elena Frances Lahore Ward, and a Bachelor of Architectural Studies. Hei Jun Park, and a Bachelor of Architectural Studies. Sukshma Sri Krishna Paranjape. Sean Kibum Park. Rachel Ann Piper. Vasilije Rakovic. Alexandra Mary Smith. Lauren Mary Jane Spear. Marina Stojanovic. Kate Elizabeth Turner. Yi Jin Yoon. To the degree of Master of Architecture Professional with Second Class Honours, First Division, Justin Dylan Barches. Jamie Harris Barter. Taylor Chan. Nicole Cherie Dorr. Carl Calvin DeMello. Charlotte Louise Farquharson. Aaron Cavill Hills. Yosef Evrel Consumido Kagawan. Grace Yi Kung. Hyun Kung Lee. Lydia Ion Liu. Joshua Overend Clark. Yuk Chi Pang. Samuel Jonathan Peters. Solhan Biol. Alexander James Sullivan Brown. Alan Young Sisome Sin. Stacey Ann Vallis, Sulin Wong, Malia Tanya Jolin Ta'a I Pule Ono I Salafi West. To the degree of Master of Architecture Professional with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Rasha Alasafi. Madeline Alice Clark. Samantha Dawn Harrison. Jimin Jun. Hyojin Kim, and a Bachelor of Architectural Studies. Vanessa ZK Liu. Emma Catherine Mannion. Meng Yang. Anjali Ravi Kumar Pondicherry. Shen Yifei. Katerina Vivian Scudder. Annabelle Laura Standage. Louis Tong. Lee Wang. Samuel Junjie Wong. To the degree of Master of Architecture Professional, Carlop Chin. Nan Gao. Haixin Huang. Si Yan Grace Leung. Jay Wuxin. To the degree of Master of Dance Studies with Second Class Honours, First Division, Timizi Vanan Vishnu Narayana Swam. And a Postgraduate Diploma in Dance Studies with Distinction. To the degree of Master of Fine Arts with First Class Honours, Selena Djurjic. And a Bachelor of Fine Arts Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division. To the degree of Master of Fine Arts with Second Class Honours, First Division, Erin Iris Nicole Fay. And a Postgraduate Diploma in Fine Arts with Merit. To the degree of Master of Fine Arts, Christopher John Brady, and a Postgraduate Diploma in Fine Arts. To the degree of Master of Music with First Class Honours, Aram Lee in Performance, and a Bachelor of Music Honours with First Class Honours in Classical Performance. Linda Lin in Performance. To the degree of Master of Music with Second Class Honours, First Division, Cindy Chen Shin Xia in Studio Pedagogy. To the degree of Master of Urban Design with First Class Honours, Duncan Philippe Rothwell. And in absentia, those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries.
I call upon an Associate Dean Academic of the Faculty of Science, Dr. Duncan McGivelray, to present graduands in that faculty.
Thank you. Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Science. The Graduate Diploma in Science. Eleanor Joanna Kroll. Peter John Weeks. David Ben Williamson. To the degree of Bachelor of Science. Ainul Husni Abu Bakr. Anna Margaret Grace Agnew. Nathan Gray Agnew. Muhammad Alauddin Al-Hafiz. Abdulaziz Anwar Al-Alhabar. Sahif Ali. Boran Akulhadari. Cade Nicholas Allen. Sanskriti Arora. Hannah Lee Asplin. Sharuthi Balachandran. Mitchell Stephen Bartlett. Danny Joseph Balke. Thomas Derek Betty. Damesh Bulla. Nicole Ellen Blackmore. Jacqueline Grace Block. Margaret Claire Bradley. Melanie Margaret Brown. Dominic Francois Burton. Janine Zabala Cachero. Jaobei Kai. Luis Miguel Adama Kamako. Gianni Camilleri. Feng Cao. Ina May Abundo Castro. Jiasha Shen. Crystal Denise Fernandez Chinitza. Chi Chung Chan. Damien Chung Kwan Chan. Hoi Tung Chan. Qian Min Chan. Shael Kavita Chand. Yang Su Chow. Chen Chi. Chen Peng Lu. Shunying Chen. Xie Yani Chen. Chuk Sing Nam. Samuel Peter Lewis Shevin. Yong Kyung Chow Choi. Hon Yong Choi. Su Ki Choi. Cheng Chu. Lee Jun Angel Chung. Laura Frances Clark. Molly Olga Coombs. Lance Hamilton Cohen. Sorry. Logan George Cribb. Nico Lawrence Cripps. Dominique Maria Janine Davies. Sally Karen Davis. Anna Bryony de Klerk. Shivandana Dipti. David Alejandro de Galdo Boniato. Mehana William Douglas. Joshua Maria Druling. Nicholas Bowen Dryden. Roxanne Iris D'Souza. Brooke Faye Eastwood. Noor Amelina Elias. Daniel Ward Elmer. Satoma Endo. Hannah Joy Erickson. Madison Ray Hamilton Eruira. Ashley Jane Evans. Luisa Salina Corina Folatau. Alexander Julius Faulkner. Oliver Winford Fawcett Griffiths. Johan Hendrik Ferreira. Oliver James Finch. Fiola Molly Ale Flores. Tara Rose Margaret Gallagher. Gao Yu Ji. Sajan Singh Gautam. Henry James Geddes. Courtney Lee Gerlach. Lucy Ellison Schofield Gervin. Goldie Guerra. Martin Joseph Gerling Butcher. Fuchsia Dawn Goldsmith. Shanti Kathleen Gore. James Elliott Grant. Yeah. Shannon Augusta Grant Mackey. Kirsty Lee Margaret Gray. Stephanie Jean Greville. Brandon Graham Norton Gertrude. Brigard S. Habib. Reno Sophia Haddo. Nicole Lee Hairiwa. Su Min Han. Jared Luke Harvey. Grant James Lancashire Hawthorne. Sarah Frances Haxel. Zhang He. Kovinani Tefa'o Helu. He mata Mateina Napia Tiana Herman. Rose Louise Abat Hernandez. Nicole Laura Heron. Naomi Vedashaki Hiti Arachikichi. Ruwani Elizabeth Hirarachichi. Lyle Stewart Hill. Summer Holly Hodder. James Hene Hoffman. Ifan Shu. Puyan Irampur. Laura Marjorie James. Alban Nikola Jelicic. Esther Maria Joe. Yeah. Yep. Farhan Adrian Yonker. Sean Michael Jordan. Jaden Insuk Yong. Su Wu Jong. Inas M. Kadim. Mo Kafil. Alexandra Jamie Tan Kai Fong. Colette Patricia Kalolo. Marisham Pereira Karuwasam Peradora Pege. Jeanette Karthak. Matthew Frederick Kempkes. Bailey Portia Kench. Prem Karai. Daehyun Kim. Jaehyun Kim. Georgia Elizabeth Grace Kirschberg. James Peruela Robert Cora. Ksenia Nikolaevna Kovaleva. Ramil Ravikesh Kumar. James Hoi Kit Kung. Brooke Shushran Kwai. Peter Siyun Kwon. Mark Eldridge Feliciano Lafredes. Sarisa Bianca Mascarina La Paz. Hon Lok Lau. Drew Preston Le Fleming Hall. Jin Wu Lee. Na Gyung Lee. On Bong Cliff Lee. Yung Jung Lee. Senai Moses Leniston Kasai. Teresa Mele Leoto Siuli VL Siufatu. Bai Yi Lee. Manri Lee. Shu Xing Lee. Ying Keely. Yu Feng Li. Victoria Liang. Monique Liebenberg. Li Tong Lim. Donna Chia Sun Lin. Hao Yuan Lin. Po Heng Lin. Jia Yi Lu. Jing Yuan Liu. Richard Anthony Lobb. Emma Catherine Lodge. Simona Flawless Lockney. Kelvin Liu. Epinesa Victoria Lotulelele. Henry Hung K. Lui. Jasmine Mui Lu Lo. Xiao Wei Lu. Xiao Yi Lu. Micah Reed Madsen. Tupu Vasiti Makahunununiu. Yuri Sergeyevich Malashkin. Awan Mansa. William Edward Marson. Matthew Liam Masters. Stephanie Rachel Sarah Matheson. Christy Louise McCollum. Joshua Hugh McDonald. Kyle Jordan McDonald. Daniel Rhys McDougall. Damon James McKibben. Brian John McNeil. Samuel James Metcalf. Martin Joseph Meyer. Amy K. Mincher. Fazana Medadi. Mohammed Sadiq Kaubang. Andrew Samir Sabri Malharab. Niknu Farahin Binti Mohammed Kamara Zolomon. Anna Lily Morgan. Matthew James Lynn Munro. Surrey Naidu. Alassani Green Lees Namoa. Nawal Nazaruddin. Te Amohare Erihapiti Nata Arangamate. Kimberly Rose Nichols. Grace Marie Nahot. Jamie Kyle Noble. Lava soane no fa'aki folau. City Sophia Norden. Fergus William Biddle Norton. Sheldon Luke Noons. Kim Nigel Offren. Daniel Ryan O'Keefe. Lloyd Kaju Ong. Samuel Joseph Page. Dhruv Deepak Kumar Panja. Alan Pang. Manu Tangarua Anaru Papunieles. Ashley Ann Parks. Maria Abigail Alam Pasquale. Daresh Prashant Patel. Georgia Jean Patterson. Zachariah Rajpal. Chantrell Indira Prendergast. Elise Michelle Penning. Aruni Chamadaya Pereira. Dana Chadwick Perry. Vincent Poliwidi. Chloe Louise Potts. Yanita Prakash. Vikrash Prakash. Mirasapini Pupuali. Hong Qian. Jared Isaac Mangelman Kihano. Aishwarya Rahi. Sharath Rao. Priyanta Anushka Ravi. James Terence Jess Razy Watts. Elsa Murray Renton. Matthew Adam Richardson. Sean Rhys Roberts. Brittany Ann Robertson. Catherine Ann Ryder. Micah Gabutin Sabeu. Hannah Elizabeth Sags. Paolo Amanaki Lele Samate. Shalini Shajestni. Yusuke Isano. Javier Marcel Santos. Sopanya Sarath. Juliet Mary Shaw. Edmund Gashing Shen. Hong Liang Philip Shi. Yoshika Shimazaki. Arnold Akshay Singh. Christina Pyar Singh. Nehal Prinshika Singh. Shukjeet Singh. Siami Sok. Janelle Jose Kavita Solo. Song Eugene. Nikita Laurel Supan. Jennifer Elsa Steele. Emily Rebecca Stevens. Terry Winona Stiles. Xuan Su. Ruchin Su. Kai Sun. Aisha Suresh Kumar. Theophilus Christian Surahimsa. Darren Mengho Gonzalez Tan. Caitlin Margaret Tat.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Samson Setu on vocal, accompanied by Claire Corbell on piano, will now perform V. Ravizzo by Vincenzo Bellini.
Il bosco è vicino la fattoria. Vi ravviso, o luoghi ameni, sin qui lieti, in cui sarei. Non trovo. trovo più.
Thank you, Samson and Claire, for that wonderful performance. Would you please join with me once again in thanking them? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Science, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Seth Joseph Tetley Jones. Gabriel Miles Thompson DeWitt. Mary Lauren Therese Etionko. Donald Jr. Tony. Robert Francis Tremaine. Madeline Ruby Truswich. Tala Tuala. Pupunu Lolohia Junior Tukuafu. Gary Tomoina Waka Ture. Pamela Jane Unkovich. Samantha Hope Van Ryn. Sean Robert Verity. Brendan Liam Miles Vernal. Govathanan Vetharanyam. Kate Elizabeth Waimati Walker. Chen Wang. Lin Feng Wang. Shi Ting Wang. Shi Xuan Wang. Daniel William Ward. Jasmine Louise Ward. Xie Chi Wei. Alicia Louise Wells. Robbie Nguyen. Michaela Jo Wheeler. Nicole Ann Wheeler. Ellie Bernice Whelan. Matthew Peter Elias Wilcox. Nathaniel Chit Wu. Jaden Ian Colin Woodhead. Kirby Louisa Wotherspoon. Yun Yue Wu. Zihao Wu. Xu Zhu. Yun Huang Shui. Noel Yeldos. Jia Hui Yi. Jason Ka-Shing Yong. Jiang Wan Yun. Abby Young. Callum Kun Yuan Young. Jared Lloyd Young. Megan Ann Younger. Silu Yu. Shi Ji Yuan. Zi Yuan Zeng. Pei Yu Zhang. Zhao Sheng Zhang. Zhang Yun. Shi Yi Zhao. Yi Meng Zhao. Hao Zheng. Sheng Sheng Zhu. Zhu Lin. Ya Tong Zhao. Chancellor, the Dean of the Faculty of Science, Professor John Hosking, will present further graduates in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Technology with First Class Honours, Cha Han Do Fan. To the degree of Bachelor of Technology with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Liang Shu Yang. Yibin Yao. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Conjoint, Margot Amelie Lucia Iri, and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar in Arts, Phoebe Margaret Charters Ball, and a Bachelor of Arts. Andre Michael Belve, and a Bachelor of Arts. Samuel Zach Byfleet, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Mingbin Chun and a Bachelor of Arts. Yi Chu Chun and a Bachelor of Arts. John Muro and a Bachelor of Music. Samantha Rose Collings and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alyssa Nicole DeVelta and a Bachelor of Arts. Samuel Kenneth Godfrey Drinkwater and a Bachelor of Commerce. Michael Peter Edkins and a Bachelor of Commerce. Justin Tan Garlick and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sarah May Gray and a Bachelor of Nursing. Amelia Louise Keenan and a Bachelor of Commerce. Matthew Nigel Kiernander and a Bachelor of Commerce. Hayden Robert Knowles and a Bachelor of Commerce. Carming Philip Kwok and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sonny Lam and a Bachelor of Arts. Wendy Wing Yuan Lam and a Bachelor of Arts. Samantha Hui Yun Lu and a Bachelor of Commerce. Brandon Pierre Lipman and a Bachelor of Commerce. Anna Louise Mace and a Bachelor of Arts. Cherie Grace Irinui Mangu and a Bachelor of Arts. Joanna Heather McCullum and a Bachelor of Arts. Natalie Renee Morse and a Bachelor of Arts. Brian Goodson Eng and a Bachelor of Commerce. Min Kwong Nyan and a Bachelor of Arts. Quinn Chian and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jonathan Underwood and a Bachelor of Commerce. Amelia Lee Vanille and a Bachelor of Arts. Xiao Wang and a Bachelor of Arts. Kenju Wong and a Bachelor of Arts. Daniel Jason Yip and a Bachelor of Commerce. Postgraduate Diploma in Applied Psychology with Merit. Catherine Ann Southcombe. Postgraduate Diploma in Forensic Science with Merit. Lorna Sully Phillips and a Bachelor of Arts and a Bachelor of Science conjoint. Postgraduate Diploma in Forensic Science, Thomas Patrick Mascara. Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Distinction, Samuel John Dunleavy in Wine Science. Shitong Wang in Food Science. Rachel Joseph John in Geography. Alistair Bruce Kendrick in Biological Sciences. Megan Cecily Kerr Phillips in Biological Sciences. Vivian Emily Cordina in Wine Science. Amy Louise Brunton Martin in Biological Sciences. Xiaoqi Cha Asang in Food Science. Haojing Qian in Food Science. Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Merit. Andrew Ayas Affable in Marine Science. Chuan Win Chuan in Biomedical Science. C. Loy Chin in Mathematics. Sunny Mile Roshantha Fernando in Biomedical Science. Vamshi Krishna Gadapali in Applied Mathematics. Chun Yang Hao in Food Science. Philip Edward Maxwell Hook in Geography. Jiang Mullen in Food Science. Kerr Liu in Biosecurity and Conservation. Sachindri Rana in Wine Science. Xuan Song in Food Science. Jun Su in Food Science. Wan Xiao in Chemistry. Xiaorui Wang in Pharmacology. Wen Ting Zhao in Food Science. Postgraduate Diploma in Science, Naveen Ashok Chand in Biological Sciences. Sheldon Brando Dangarten Benito in Environmental Management. Gemma Rose Dowsett in Environmental Science and a Bachelor of Science. Jing Liu in Biological Sciences. Albert Ong in Food Science. Hasmita Kiran Singh in Biological Sciences. Shuping Xu in Computer Science. Matthew Thomas Wakrar Yul in Environmental Management. Anchi Zhang in Food Science. Li Zheng in Biological Sciences. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with First Class Honours. Donna Madhushani Gunawardena in Medicinal Chemistry. Erica Jane Marshall in Biological Sciences. Alyssa Sir Yong Ying Ong in Computer Science and a Bachelor of Science. Benjamin Sean Reed in Biological Sciences. Ho Kwan Song in Statistics. Ming Foon Wong in Mathematics. Zhongchun Yang in Computer Science. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Stuart Anthony Bradley in Computer Science. Ian Kenneth Rivera Damaran in Chemistry. Glenn Guo in Statistics. James Ian Stuart Taylor in Biological Sciences. Xiaowen Zhang in Geography. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Panding Huang in Statistics. To the degree of Master of Bioscience Enterprise with First Class Honours, Priya Pemibana. Munju Maxi. Megan Nikita Naidu. To the degree of Master of Bioscience Enterprise with Second Class Honours, First Division, Zufu Jian. Lucy Margaret Forrester. Simrit Gill. Hope Bonnie Harding. Joelle Marie Raphael. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with First Class Honours, Miranda Claire Fraser in Food Safety. Journey Luo in Food Safety. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours, First Division, Nishita Bala Murala Krishna in Data Science. Aaron Gopalan near Kolasiri in Data Science. Ron Lee in Data Science. Utkarsha Mishra in Digital Security. Ella A.H. Shublak in Digital Security. Chun Xing in Data Science. Wen-Ten Yang in Data Science. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Sanjid Rahman in Data Science. Ahmed Omar Yusuf in Data Science. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies, Pushpinder Kaur Chadha in Mathematics Education. Osela Tilamai Uili in Mathematics Education. Venu Vindravanam Parameswaran Anair in Data Science. Yihuan Wang in Data Science. To the degree of Master of Science with First Class Honours, Rosemary Hazel Arts in Geology and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Merit in Geology. Anna Leiborn Boss in Biomedical Science. Denver Desmond Brito in Biomedical Science. Sunyin Chung in Food Science and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Merit in Food Science. Jessica Collette Robina Laws-Devitt in Biosecurity and Conservation. Emma Edney Brown in Biosecurity and Conservation. Sophia Daniela Garcia Gavilanes in Psychology. Rose Georgina Gregerson in Environmental Science. Amy Rochelle Houston in Psychology. Elaine Huang in Food Science. Kimchan Nadishka Jawardner in Biological Sciences. Maria Kalukina in Biological Sciences. Okay. Sean Ko Yang Yang in Computer Science. Wingshan Lai in Biomedical Science. Stacey Marianne Lamont in Biosecurity and Conservation. Fengyao Li in Statistics and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Merit in Statistics. Haowen Li in Biomedical Science. Christopher Bo Liu in Statistics and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Distinction in Statistics. Lucas John McDonald in Earth Sciences. Charlton J. Martin in Biomedical Science. Emerald Mary McPhee in Psychology. Libby Sarah Mertens in Biological Sciences and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Distinction in Biological Sciences. Laurie John Lee Mitchell in Marine Science. Emma Kirsten Morgan in Psychology. Caitlin Renee Marie Oyagawa in Pharmacology. Rachel Passmore in Mathematics. Jamie Allen Powell in Biological Sciences. Jaya Davina Prasad in Physiology. Ivan Rivera in Statistics. Brenda Benner Silva Sakira in Pharmacology. Oh. Anna. Anna Elizabeth Smith in Earth Sciences. Titan Intius in Environmental Management. Lisa Lee Tsai in Geography. Reuben Thomas Wilkinson in Biological Sciences. Dinan Yang in Statistics. Stanley Vitier Tsin Yin Yun in Biomedical Science and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science and Biomedical Science. To the degree of Master of Science with Second Class Honours First Division. Jason Jayanti Dana in Optometry. Saloni Liao in Statistics. Kunal Marav in Biological Sciences. Callum James Templeton in Marine Science. Kaiman Yuan in Biomedical Science. To the degree of Master of Science with Second Class Honours, Second Division. Kate Gemma Burson in Geography. Kenichi Furushima in Medical Statistics. Paul Junior Harris in Mathematics. Mushuan Lee in Statistics. Catherine Ann Longstaff in Geography. Heather Briar McClelland in Forensic Science. Banyarika Ravindaran in Statistics. To the degree of Master of Science, Carolyn Marie Eichler in Psychology. Bei Hu in Statistics and a Postgraduate Diploma in Science in Statistics. Arishma Aranesh Lata in Forensic Science. Minzi Liu in Environmental Science. Yifei Zhang in Psychology. To the degree of Master of Speech Language Therapy Practice, Mulamu Fipule Lee.
I now call upon the Vice Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Psychology, Jacinda Grace Calkin. Jacinda investigated psychologists' views of antidepressants given their experience of working therapeutically with depressed clients. This included any dilemmas that arise and the approaches, including decision-making, that they adopt in relation to antidepressant treatment and psychotherapy for depression. Jacinda. University Doctoral Scholar Phoebe Robertson-Malloy. Phoebe explored the development and maintenance of depression within an interpersonal framework. She considered the impact of specific behavioural and cognitive factors associated with depression on support experiences within romantic relationships and the effects of this on depressive symptomatology across time. Her findings have important clinical applications for the treatment of depressive disorders. University Doctoral Scholar Elizabeth Louise Ogden. Elizabeth looked at general practitioners' understanding of the causes of depression and factors which influence their treatment decisions for depression, with a particular focus on their views on antidepressants. She found that there was a mismatch between general practitioners' views on antidepressants and their treatment practices. Anna Shum Pierce. Anna explored young men's experiences of physical, psychological, and sexual abuse in heterosexual relationships, their perspectives on seeking help, and the views of their peers about abuse against men. Her findings support the need for specific education about the issue and support for men who experience abuse, and the need to highlight the limitations of a narrow approach to abuse and its consequences. Tingya Wong. Tingya invited young Māori people to voice their experiences of undergoing assessments in a mental health service to help health professionals better understand the specific preferences and needs of this age group. The study highlighted young people's values towards the development of a therapeutic relationship, their ability to exercise agency, and the need for culturally responsive professionals. The study showed how positive assessment experiences can provide therapeutic benefits in young people's lives. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, University doctoral scholar Natalie Melanie Gwyneth Allen in Urban Design. Natalie investigated the relationships between delivering urban intensification in Auckland and enhancing the quality of urban life experienced by residents. She interviewed residents currently living in higher density housing and asked them about their housing choices, aspirations, and the role of urban amenities in meeting their quality of urban life expectations. Natalie. Nihan Ademir in chemistry. Nihan developed novel and cost-effective procedures to be used in the development of conducting polymer-based DNA biosensors. These sensors can be miniaturized and used in the field to detect several illnesses. University doctoral scholar Damir Azhar in computer science. In order to make effective decisions when embarking on a web development project, a manager needs to be able to accurately predict the length of the development cycle, a process known as web effort estimation. While many estimation techniques have been investigated, none has proven conclusively to be the best. Damir looked at combining accurate estimation techniques to create ensembles of these techniques that consistently performed well when used for web effort estimation. Damir. University doctoral scholar Edward Paul Beetham in geography. Eddie investigated the impact of sea level rise on mid-ocean atoll islands by first resolving how environmental conditions influence the mechanics of wave run-up and inundation on Funafuti Atoll in Tuvalu. A high-resolution numerical model was then used to develop a globally applicable morphology-based index for assessing reef island vulnerability to wave overtopping with sea level rise. Ashley Kate Bullott in psychology. Ashley investigated common coexisting conditions in autism spectrum disorder using electroencephalography as the main research technique. The aim of her research was to determine whether anxiety and attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, when they present together with autism, are in fact separate conditions or better conceptualised through the autism diagnosis. Ashley. University doctoral scholar Etuate Koka in computer science. Etuate designed and implemented a global network of stations measuring the quality of intercontinental internet connections. A particular focus of his research was the Pacific Islands, where internet via satellite is often the only connectivity option. Together with partners in the Pacific, in Europe, and at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, Itarate installed experimental technology in a number of Pacific Island countries to demonstrate that this can result in more efficient connectivity. Ransi Devendra in chemistry. Ransi investigated the reaction mechanisms of selected tin and titanium compounds as catalysts used in polyurethane synthesis during experimental and computational methods. Polyurethanes are widely used in our daily life in applications including coatings, adhesives, automotive parts, sports equipment, footwear, and insulation. The new knowledge from his study has allowed the polyurethane industry to improve the quality of its products. Ransi. University doctoral scholar Alea Louise DeVette in psychology. Alea explored why, when remembering our past, we make errors where elements from one memory are mistakenly transferred into another memory. Alea found that imagining detailed and plausible scenarios increases the likelihood of these memory errors. Moreover, older adults make more of these errors, particularly when presented with familiar memory features in an incorrect combination. University doctoral scholar Do Duc Tan in mathematics. Tan's research showed that functions in the domain of a degenerate elliptical operator can be approximated by smooth functions. In one dimension, he obtained a full characterization of the approximation, while in higher dimension, he provided sufficient conditions. These results enable us to simplify and extend the analysis of degenerate elliptical operators. Stephen John Fitzherbert in geography. Stephen investigated the articulation of diverse Māori economies with other economies in processes of economy making. Working for Māori organisations and Tāua growers, he examined how they mobilise and negotiate articulation. The research puts economy in front of cultural politics, centres the multiplicity of economic practice, and reveals diverse possibilities in the largely post-Treaty of Waitangi era. University doctoral scholar Shishe Wele Gabrigiorgas in mathematics. Shishe's research made contributions to the mathematical analysis of algorithms for solving certain computational problems. These problems arise from cryptography and have applications in secure key exchange and cloud computing. The two main topics in the thesis are the discrete logarithm problem in binary elliptic curves and the approximate common divisor problem. Matthew Donald Hammond in psychology. Matt investigated how people's gender stereotypes influence their romantic relationships. His research showed that men's and women's agreement with sexist beliefs predicted patterns of relationship-related behaviours and beliefs that function to maintain gender inequalities. James Jong in biological sciences. James investigated structural and functional aspects of a protein that plays an essential role in assembly line biosynthetic processes in two disease-causing bacteria. The study was aimed at inhibiting these processes as a new route to developing therapies for tuberculosis and Pseudomonas infections. James. University doctoral scholar Andrew Allen Keane in mathematics. Andrew analysed a conceptual model for the climate system responsible for El Niño events, which is a warming of the Pacific Ocean occurring approximately every 4 to 7 years. The model focuses on fundamental mechanisms of the climate system. A state-of-the-art bifurcation analysis clarified what role feedback loops with time delays play in producing realistic El Niño behaviour. Jennifer Kuhn in Biological Sciences. Jennifer investigated the anti-inflammatory effects of indigenous New Zealand honey produced by bees feeding on different floral sources, including the native trees Kānaka, Manuka and Rewarewa, as well as clover. She discovered that Rewarewa honey is the most potent inhibitor of oxygen radicals from inflammatory cells in the blood, and she was able to partially purify the active component from the crude honey. Her research could lead to the development and production of new value-added products from New Zealand honey, a significant export earner in the country's economy. Eva Kong in psychology. Eva examined long-term potentiation, a phenomenon that underlies learning and memory formation. She employed a non-invasive paradigm to measure electrical brain activity in healthy human participants and was able to demonstrate that this paradigm resulted in changes in the strength of the connections between human cortical cells. As more is known about this relatively new paradigm, it demonstrates the potential for it to be applied to understanding neurocognitive disorders in clinical settings. Shu Ki Lam in food science. Shu Ki investigated the effect of a protein cross-linker, known as transglutaminase, on the changes in physical and chemical properties of skimmed milk under acidic and alkaline conditions and with added ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. The findings of this research can potentially allow the manufacture of new dairy products with novel functional and physical properties. University doctoral scholar Evett Jan Loof in biological sciences. Evett investigated the role of the brain protein neuroserpin in a new environment, the human immune system. By applying knowledge of neuroserpin's functions in the nervous system to human T cells, he was able to identify new roles for neuroserpin in T cell activation and T cell migration. These findings have led to new hypotheses about how T cell movement through blood vessel walls is controlled and how interactions between T cells and other immune cells regulate T cell activation. Alana Bernice McCambridge in exercise sciences. Alana conducted a series of elegant neurophysiological experiments with human participants to examine a neural pathway between the cortex, brainstem, and spinal cord. Her final study examined patients with severe arm impairment after stroke, for whom there are no current treatment options. Alana found that a novel, non-invasive brain stimulation technique could facilitate this pathway and improve the arm movements of patients. Cameron Angus McLean in computer science. Cameron investigated pragmatic solutions to the problem of sharing, understanding, and reusing knowledge related to laboratory experiments in support of scientific reproducibility. He developed a knowledge representation framework based on the notion of design patterns, extended this into the domain of laboratory science, and demonstrated how including design patterns along other e-science tools can improve the epistemological adequacy of our scientific record. Esther Dinah Menken in statistics. Complex deterministic computer simulation models are used to describe and predict real-world systems in many areas of research and discovery. However, researchers are increasingly interested in characterising their uncertainty. In an approach that is novel to New Zealand's primary industry sector, Esther proposed and demonstrated a Bayesian methodology that can identify and quantify uncertainty in biophysical computer models. This methodology will facilitate their further use as effective research and management tools for agricultural and horticultural crops. University doctoral scholar Mojgan Mamari in computer science. Referential integrity is a property of data which ensures that relationships between data tables are meaningful. Mojgan developed new techniques for the handling of referential integrity within standard database systems. The techniques were shown to improve the performance of fundamental data processing tasks, such as database queries, updates, and repairs. Meet Vijay Kumar Mistry in chemistry. Meet worked on synthesis and characterisation of cobalt-3 complexes that have been designed using ligands, which are structural analogues of anti-cancer compounds. These cobalt complexes were designed to serve as models for potential prodrugs activated by hypoxia and designed to target cancer cells. Seongju Nam in chemistry. A surface covered only by pentagons forms an intriguing pattern known as Penrose tiling, the subject of much analysis by mathematicians. Seong's project sought to recreate Penrose tiling using molecular pentagons deposited on a gold or graphite surface. Seong designed and chemically synthesized pentagonal molecules, and studied their properties, with the aim of better understanding the factors required to control the precise geometrical arrangements of molecules on surfaces. University doctoral scholar Helen Waimari Nathan in biological sciences. Helen used motion-activated cameras to study the cryptic behaviour of invasive rats around pest control devices in native forest. Her analysis identified the key factors influencing the probability of rats encountering and interacting with the devices. By improving understanding of the spatial and behavioural processes underpinning pest control, Helen's findings are directly relevant to efforts to make New Zealand predator-free. Nicolaas Jacobus Nieuwenhuizen in biological sciences. Neil studied the transcription factors that regulate fruit ripening in apples and kiwi fruit. These transcription factors are proteins that bind to DNA and can turn on or off target genes during ripening and thus influence the ripening rate of fruit. Several novel transcription factors were identified that are likely to be key ripening regulators in apples, kiwi fruit, and in other fruit. Kenneth John Olijar Jr. in chemistry. Ken looked at the increasing biologically active compounds found in New Zealand white wines. In addition to this research, he also developed active packaging for food preservation using bioactive compounds extracted from the winery wastes. Hamie Reaver Page Park in Psychology. Hamie examined the effect of schizotypy in healthy adults. These are non-clinical personality traits that are qualitatively similar to schizophrenia symptoms. She found that highly schizotypal individuals displayed neural and behavioural differences akin to schizophrenia patients, adding to the evidence that subtle changes may already be present prior to the onset of any clinical symptoms. University doctoral scholar Glenn Stewart Robertson in computer science. Glenn investigated techniques for machine learning strategic behaviour using minimal domain-specific information. He developed a method for building behaviour tree models by analysing sequences of player actions and contributed a reusable data set through an improved process for extracting information from the logs of experts playing the real-time strategy game StarCraft. Soo Jong Son in Biological Sciences. Amy looked at the structures of ORF virus, tuberculosis, and breast cancer-associated proteins in order to investigate their significance in initiation and development of the diseases. Her research also included synthetically recreating the target proteins using chemical methods. William Joseph Thornton in architecture. William investigated a large cross-section of urban spaces from two contrasting cities and explored a different approach to understanding the kinds of spaces we encounter in the city. William's research offers support to designers, urban planners, and policymakers in their efforts to provide urban spaces while accommodating human needs and preferences. Tomohiro Uchiyama in mathematics. Tomohiro's research was in group theory, the branch of mathematics that studies symmetries of objects and their abstraction. He studied algebraic and geometric properties of subgroups of exceptional groups, and in particular those subgroups that are completely reducible. Tomohiro. University doctoral scholar Michelle van Rensburg in chemistry. Michelle studied a range of compounds for potential use in the treatment of Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, and amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, as well as a secondary group of compounds targeted as chemotherapeutic agents against triple-negative breast cancer. Lena Francesca Weissert in environmental science. Lena used a wide range of methods applied at different spatial and temporal scales to investigate the role of urban vegetation in the urban carbon cycle. She demonstrated that urban vegetation in subtropical cities dominated by evergreen vegetation may play a more important role in mitigating local carbon dioxide emissions than is observed in temperate cities. University doctoral scholar Stefan Wender in computer science. Stefan used a combination of different machine learning algorithms to create an artificial intelligence agent that learned how to autonomously manage groups of units in the real-time strategy game StarCraft. He achieved this by hierarchically decomposing the problem space into individual, numerous components that, integrated together, addressed complex tactical and reactive tasks. University doctoral scholar Eletra Isabel Williams in forensic science. Eletra developed and optimised a novel method for labelling forensically relevant cell types with fluorescent probes. She also showed that this labelling method could be used with isolation techniques to purify forensic samples. This provides a potential new tool for forensic investigators to process biological evidence of mixed origin and generate DNA profiles from problematic samples. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a doctoral degree in the Faculty of Creative Arts and Industries and the Faculty of Science.
We are now nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And while you are standing, it would be a great opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. Please. Thank you. This concludes this meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of the programme.